Connection established.
It's Realtor Roundtable, available on iTunes, Stitcher, and anywhere on PhillipeConsulting.com. A place real estate professionals come to better their business. Here to help you better your real estate business. What more do you want? Listen, subscribe, and share. Now, let's get to it.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to this week's Realtor Roundtable. My name is Darren Phillippe, CEO of Phillippe Consulting and CEO of Keller Williams, the Marketplace here in Vegas. And thank you so much for listening and taking the time to listen to this podcast. Thank you so much for subscribing if you have been listening to this on a regular basis. If you're not listening on a regular basis, do me a favor. Subscribe to that baby, because I'm consistently on the 1st and the 15th of every single month. I put out a new episode, and hopefully you guys find some great value. I've gotten some great feedback, and this podcast is growing. So thank you so much for being a part of it. Thank you for tuning in and sharing and everything else you guys are doing. So anyway, how's the summer going for you? How's the market and how's the business? This is always an exciting time of year. And holy cow, I'm not joking. This has probably been the best real estate year of my career, and I see only better things happening. I'm really excited. The agents that I'm coaching are finding success, and we'll end up having some interviews on some future podcasts with some of these guys that I've been working with. So anyway. Loving life. Business is definitely good. Life is good. So anyway, I thought this was going to be, I haven't done this for a while. I haven't talked a little technology geek, for a while. And I thought it'd be kind of fun to get back into it a little bit. I was thinking, you know, all of us are aware of social media now and how many, there's so much stuff out there and there's so many things for you to learn as a real estate agent. And of course you wear so many hats as a real estate agent and you're like, ah, crap. Everybody tells me I need to get more involved in social media or I need to leverage technology and things like that. So we start getting involved and we use Facebook and, because that's where everybody's at. And then people think, hey, you should probably get on LinkedIn too. So you create a LinkedIn account, but then you don't really know what to do with it because it's just there. And then, you know, there's Twitter out there, which is very popular, but I don't know what the heck to do with that as a real estate agent. And then there's this thing called Google Plus. Who knows what that's all about? I hear it's just another Facebook, and so it's no big deal or whatever. So I thought would be kind of cool is to just kind of cover some things that are kind of cool that you could do with social media that you may not know that you can do. So anyway, this is, that's what we're going to talk about today. And I hope you guys like this. First I was sitting there thinking about, we'll go ahead and start with Facebook. Now we all, of course, know how to work Facebook. I would say for the most part, everybody who's listening probably has an account. Some of you guys may use it at a really high level because, with Facebook, man, it's an awesome, awesome tool to be able to develop relationships with your sphere, develop relationships with your contacts, and it's a great way to brand your business and you can really do some really cool things. But most of it, we're just kind of following up with our friends and our family and kind of see what's going on with our family across the country or whatever. And so I thought, did you guys know on Facebook, when you have a business page, because you have your individual page, and then of course you can create a business page. Did you know on your business page, you can create these custom buttons and they're clickable, just like kind of its own little website type thing. And when you click on these buttons, that could be any image that you want, that you could actually, when you click on the button, it could do quite a few different things. It could actually bring your website into Facebook. So if you have an IDX set up on your website where people can search for homes on the MLS or whatever, you could actually click this button that's on Facebook and pull that whole, your whole website, that whole search into your Facebook. And people are on Facebook searching for homes on your website. Pretty cool, huh? You probably didn't know you could do that. You know, you could also create these landing pages that when they go to your Facebook page, your business Facebook page, that when they click on it or when they come to your page, it will actually show a message that pertains to that person who's coming there. So if I'm first time I've ever gone to your business page and I've never liked your business page before, you can make it so it'll say a certain message. And if they have liked it or they have shared your Facebook page with a certain amount of people, you could actually show a different message, which is kind of cool. So these little buttons that you can create on your on this Facebook business page, you can pull in websites, you can send them to other places. There's a lot of really, really cool things that I think a lot of people on Facebook don't even realize you can do. So anyway, I think that's really cool, and I wanted to share that with you. So let's talk a little bit about, since you guys know a lot about Facebook, I'm going to get into this thing called Twitter. Now, Twitter is not me and Kim Kardashian following up and seeing what kind of shoes she got. It's not my kid talking about what he ate and stuff like that. Twitter is a pretty awesome tool where you basically use 140 characters to say or share whatever you want. You could add images, you could add links to websites, blogs, videos, all those different types of things. But it's a very succinct way of being able to communicate with people. Now, there is a really cool thing about Twitter. Did you guys know that 50% of the people that you follow on Twitter, when you follow them, they will actually follow you back? So for every 10 people that you follow on Twitter, those 10 people, 5 of them will follow you back. So what's the big deal with that, right? So think of it this way. If I knew my niche market, if there was a certain group of people that I loved working with, so for instance, if I was really loving working with teachers, I could actually target teachers that are in my community and follow them. And what happens is 50% of the time, they'll follow me back. Well, big whoop, Darren. Who cares about that? Well, because they have other features where, first of all, you're able to develop a following of people that are your target market. So, for instance, I've got 3,300 people following me on Twitter. Guess the percentage of the people that are following me on Twitter. How many of them are real estate professionals? Okay, I'm going to pull this percentage out of my tail, but I'm telling you 95% of those people that are following me are real estate professionals somehow or another. And the way I was able to do that is by following them, and 50% of them will follow me back. So that's really cool because I can now start targeting groups of people. And now when I say things on Twitter, they will follow me and follow me back, right? That's pretty sweet. So now I've got a following that is my niche. The cool thing is also on Twitter, you can actually use a third-party tool that will do automatic replies, direct messages to people who follow you. So check this out. People you follow, they'll follow, 50% of them will follow you back, right? When they follow you back, they get a message that's sent to them that can say whatever you want. That's 130, 140 characters. And on that, in that, you could actually put a link on your website. So you could say something like this. Thanks for following me. If you ever want to check out homes in your area, search for homes here. And it's a link to your search page. Pretty cool, huh? You're able to start focusing on people that are your target audience. And then you could follow, when they follow you back, you could send them a direct message that drives them to your site. It's a great way for you to be able to build a followership and direct people to your website. I love it. Pretty sweet. All right, so that's Twitter. And the other cool thing is you could do that same following and them following you back on Google+. So it's not just a Twitter thing. All right, so let's talk a little bit about Google+. Google+ is I like to describe Google+. It's kind of like it's got features of Facebook and it's got features of Twitter. And then you've got Google, who runs the search world, and it's their social media platform. And Google+ is awesome. I believe as time goes on, Google+ is going to be one of the main ways to do social media. It's very powerful now, but even more so, I think, as the future comes on. But did you know on Google+, you can create invitations where you can invite people that are following you to something like an event, like an open house? And what it does, it actually puts that information in their calendar. So they're driving along, they look in the calendar, oh, I wonder what I'm doing on Saturday afternoon. Weird, I've got this appointment. They click on the appointment, it's got all the information about the open house, the address, and everything like that. It's got YouTube videos, it's got links to the house and everything like that. You could actually put invitations in other people's calendars. I just think that's so dang cool. Isn't that kind of crazy? So be creative with something like that. Google+, you could also do things like this. Google Hangouts. A lot of people don't know quite what a Google Hangout is. All it is basically Skype through Google. Google+, I should say. It allows you to be able to do face-to-face phone conversations, or should I say over the computer. But it's extra cool because you can add up to 10 people in the room. So you could have a group of people having a conversation on the computer. You could show them things on your computer. You can go to different websites and stuff like that. They could be looking at the things that are on your computer. So I've actually had appointments with people who were in other parts of the country face-to-face on Google+. I was able to show them some of the things on my computer, and I was able to look at them face-to-face and have this conversation as if I was there. So, so cool. Anyway. So Google+ is pretty sweet. LinkedIn is a pretty sweet tool. I think LinkedIn is probably underused by quite a few real estate agents. A lot of them, they're like, okay, I have to have a professional face to the world, but I don't really know what to do with that. Well, did you know on LinkedIn, you could actually find people that you're trying to connect. Maybe those people though won't return phone calls, or they're really influential in your community or whatever. You could actually find the people who are connected with them, connect with those people, and ask for introductions. It's just a really cool way. If a lot of times when you try to reach out to people by phone and by email, they won't respond. But if you're able to respond by social media and LinkedIn as a professional, you might be able to get a lot more people to communicate with you. So I just think it's a really cool way to reach out as a professional to other people. And then the last thing that I'm not really sure if you guys are aware of is a tool called Hootsuite. Hootsuite is a social media dashboard where you're able to run your Facebook, your Twitter, your Google+, your LinkedIn, and a couple of other social media platforms all at one spot. So you don't have to log into each one of those, make your posts, read all of those, and all that kind of stuff. You can go to one place, you can make one post, and it'll go to all of Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Google+, the business pages, everything like that. And then what it also will do is you can also schedule these posts so you can sit at one time and in 15 minutes make all your posts that are going to happen throughout the week. Pretty cool, huh? You're also able to read all of your Facebook and your Twitter and your Google+ and your LinkedIn, all of those feeds. So when people are talking about things, you could actually read them in one spot rather than having to go to all those different places. You could also create these little things that you can actually listen for certain phrases, where if someone says something like, I want to buy a house, or I hate renting, or something like that, on any of these platforms, it will alert you, and it'll show up on that dashboard too. Isn't that cool? Who knew that all of this stuff I just think it's cool that, there's these tools that we use on every single, on an everyday basis is available to us. All of this stuff is free. So if you're looking for marketing your business and looking for another way to be able to communicate with your sphere and your family, all of these social media tools are really cool. And hopefully I was able to share with you in each one of these areas, something that you're like, you're right, I didn't know that you could do that. So anyway, that being said, I'm not going to go into this too much, but I'm kind of wigging out here, guys. I'm really, really excited about something, but I'm not going to elaborate too much into it, except for this. All of those things I just got done talking about, Facebook, Twitter, Google+, LinkedIn, Hootsuite, over the last 2 years, I've been working on something. I've been working on a website called realestatetechacademy.com. So if you go to www.realestatetechacademy.com, you will go to a website that teaches real estate agents how to use technology in a real estate agent's language for the purpose of a real estate agent. Actually, probably by the time you're listening to this podcast, I will have launched, will be launching very soon, the very first product, which is social media for real estate. All it is step-by-step video tutorials teaching you how to use Facebook, Twitter, Google+, LinkedIn, and Hootsuite. And you can learn this at your own pace. You don't have to go into any classes. You don't have to try to remember and try to reproduce what you've learned when you're all at home by yourself. You're able to go to these videos and watch them step by step. And if you want to watch for an hour and then leave and come back 3 days later, or if you're trying to do something and you want to have a reference of how do I make those buttons on Facebook, you can go to the tutorials and step by step, it's going to teach you exactly how to do everything on all of those platforms. Isn't that pretty cool? So this is just my first product, but I'll get into it more later. But if you guys are curious and you want to see what Real Estate Tech Academy is all about, go to www.realestatetechacademy.com, and I want you to snoop around. Watch some of the things that are on there. Tell me what you guys think. In fact, if you want to, you could probably even subscribe to all of those tutorials. So you can get all those tutorials for Facebook, Twitter, Google+, LinkedIn, Hootsuite. It's got tons of content. You're probably looking around about 14, 15 hours of step-by-step video tutorials. That's like crazy, dude. So anyway, that's what I've been working on. And I thought, man, if I was talking about this, I had to at least introduce you guys to Real Estate Tech Academy. We will have a couple more podcasts, maybe not the next one, but the one after that, where we're going to really get into it. But check it out. I think you guys will love it. And for everybody else who has no interest in technology, or you're just a geek yourself and you don't need any of this help, thanks for listening anyway. I really do appreciate it. Please continue to listen. Make sure you share with your friends. Do set it a goal to make sure that you invite your friends that are in your office and say, hey, dude, there's this guy that's really cool. Maybe not. But you can tell him he's really cool anyway. And he's got some great ideas, and he really helps me out, and it makes me feel good for at least 15, 20 minutes every single time I listen. So anyway, thanks for listening. And you guys go check out realestatetechacademy.com and go out and take action today.
Thank you for listening to Realtor Roundtable. You can follow Darren on Twitter at DPhilippi and on Google+ at Darren Phillippe. Listen, subscribe, and share.